So it so happened that for a long, long time we did with Samson very different things. So he was mostly kind of field theory, real field theory man, and I was doing integrable models. But so then at some point, so it so happened that it got closer. And so there are certain things which are very similar now, and so I will show them, and this is one reason to talk about it on this subject, which is not very complicated. Another reason is that it is related to what I was talking about, is related to Liouville, and everybody likes Liouville. And so the third thing is that I will give some exact answers for some quantities, but so but my formulae are just conjectures which I will check, and I really don't quite know how to prove them, and probably somebody will be able to do it. So and so this is a paper based on the joint work with Zoltan Beinok, but so also it is it goes back to our joint papers with Stefano Negro. He is here. Right. So C.H. Gordon model is the simplest integrable model, so that's why I am talking about this model. It's the simplest integrable model. So here is the Lagrangian density. And so what I will be doing finally, I will compute the matrix elements of in this geometry. There is some local operator here, and so some eigenstates of Hamiltonian here and here, so in the finite volume. So I will use also, so the coupling constant is called B. I will also use this Q, which is B plus B minus 1, like in Liouville. Always we do, and P, which is like that. Just convenient notations. Sorry? I think Lagrange, okay, so say Euclidean action. So who cares? So okay? So there is a duality like that. So, and then, so the dimensionless mass scale. So this combination is self-dual. So, and then the mass of physical particle is given by this kind of awful formula. So, as usual, so and all this kind of formula are due to Alyosha Zamolodchikov, so and they are actually very important if you want to have some, if you want to make some numerics. And so this is the simplest, as I said, this is the simplest integrable model. So in the sense that, so if you think about it in Minkowski space, as in terms of scattering theory, so there is only one scalar particle, and the S matrix is the simplest possible, so you can imagine. So that's why, so this is a good laboratory for checking things. And so I will use for instead of this radius of my, so I will build a cylinder, as I said, and instead of the radius of my cylinder, I will use this R small, so dimensionless combination. And what I did not say, so here I draw this contour, so this will be when I go to UV conformal limit, so this will be important. So now how do you find the spectrum of this model? So there is something which is called Q function. So normally, so once again, so already from here, so we start something which is not quite neat, I would say, because so say in There are physically more understandable situations like, or mathematical, I don't know, a sine Gordon, where this kind of relation, so when this kind of object, Q operator, can be really defined. And sine Gordon, it cannot be really defined as far as I understand. But so let me just say, but nobody doubts what I will say now. So there is some function Q, which is the entire function in the theta plane, and so which satisfies this quadratic relation, and then different functions satisfying this relation enumerates the spectrum of the theorem. This Q behaves asymptotically with some additional condition. So it behaves asymptotically like that, yes? So then if theta k are zeros of this Q, then it is easy to see that, or it's a definition, if you wish, that Q is given by the following formula. If we define this second term here as e to epsilon, we just put it into the right-hand side, and then write something trivial, yeah. So and in this way.
It's actually not definition; it's relation, because exponential of minus epsilon is Q squared.
This is a definition. So this is a definition.
That's a definition, but that's a relation.
So this
equals that. The formula above, right? Yeah. Q equals that.
Yes.
And epsilon of theta is
you shift this guy by pi I over 2, and you shift it by minus pi I over 2 plus I0 minus I0 bach, you get this, right? So this is the tautology. But so from this tautology you get, since we wrote this Q, we immediately get this equation for the function epsilon, yes, which characterizes spectrum, and with this kernel, and in addition, so I have this. So this is kind of you can think about this epsilon as a density of continuous spectrum, and there are these particles which are kind of discrete spectrum, and so. In addition to this relation, you have finite number of equations like that. And it is we suppose that theta k are all real. And so if I require in addition that all theta k's are real, then I get the spectrum of this theory in
n sub k, what is it?
Some integers. So that good question. So I'm saying that the spectrum is parameterized by a set of integers. Okay, so yes,
positive.
These are parameters.
Ah,
no, wait, no, positive or negative?
Including zero.
I think so. Yes, yes, as usual. Yes. So, and so I put here minus s under logarithm arguments, because so s of 0 is minus 1, and it is for more convenient, so not to have jump. Right. So this is an equation. This is a system of equations which you can put on the computer and solve immediately with great precision. So then the eigenvalues so of integrals of motion. So we have, we have, what is that? Yes, we have infinite number of integrals of motion with two chiralities. So, not chiralities, but so, anyway, so ES and ES bar. So in the conformal limit, this will be indeed two chiral sets of integrals of motion, and the eigenvalues from the fixed set n, you find epsilons and theta k, and the eigenvalues are like that. And so there are these funny constants somewhere which are due to. So integrals of motion are normalized in such a way that they coincide in conformal limit with so that in conformal limit they have some simplest possible form. So I don't go into details here.
Summation with respect to k, right? Not j.
Okay. Pro. Yeah, that's quite possible. Yes, I think so. But they are close, you know, j, k.
Okay.
So not very far. So. And but if these guys are normalized in the best possible way in conformal limit, then there are some constants here, so which are due to Bajanov-Lukianov the Molotchik, when particular energy is this and momentum is that. So now of course, so with this TBA kind of equation, it's very easy to check that in for large R you will have Luescher corrections and so on and so forth. But it's more interesting to think what will happen in the ultraviolet limit when R is small. So everything essentially depends on this constant, yes? And when R is small, so the potential becomes like that. So it's long, long, long. So and so what happens is so for zero mode, I'm talking about zero mode here, and what happens is that you have reflections from these two boundaries, right? And so Bohr-Sommerfeld conditions, and the reflections are Liouville ones, because so here you have this walls are Liouville potentials. And the Liouville reflection amplitude is known very well. And so this is the Bohr-Sommerfeld quantization condition.
Isabel.
So this is exactly so. This is the integrals of motion are expressed in terms of this P like you. Like in CFT, okay? So you see, so this is for the first integral of motion. So this is the p squared minus 1 over 24 central charge is 1, and plus m is for one chirality and m bar for another chirality. And so delta is used later, is like that. And so the central charge is like that, yes, for the so. And then we identify, so I will not go into detail how exactly this, in general, how this sets of integers are identified within ultraviolet limit, so with CFT states, but so with Liouville states, but so, for example, this one, minus 2, 0, 2, corresponds to the primary field. So here L, there are primary fields which are counted by 1, 2, 3, and so on. Yes, so this L is the primary field number 4. So the spectrum of primary field is quantized because of, yes, like. And so this is the ground state. Ground state correspond to L equal 1. But so now here, this is rather high. So L equal 4, but still, for R small like that, and I don't remember what I took for B, so the ratio of integrals of motion which I compute numerically and exact values from CFT are rather reasonably good. So, so which means that with this zero mode consideration, I arrive at rather good precision. So now here is the identification just of my of this sets of integers and conformal fields. So L are different, so different primary fields. So then here are descendants. So this is simple. So here I have descendants on level 1, and so they are always unique. So here I have descendants on level two. I will have to distinguish them somehow, and they are not distinguished, of course, by the first integral of motion. I have to go to third, and so on. I probably will talk about this at the end. So now, what is my goal? My goal is to compute the diagonal matrix elements of this type for any local operators. So, local operator. There is a one-to-one identification between local operators in ultraviolet conformal field theory, or Liouville, in my case, and in massive theory. I will not explain much, but so just I will count these operators as I do in CFT. So there are primary fields. Primary fields are just exponents of phi, and so these exponents are so these primary fields are normalized by Lukyanov-Zamolodchikov one-point function. If you don't know what is this, so forget about it. It will be later. So, but this is an important thing. And so now, the main point, which I advocate for a long time, actually, so is that when you are doing integrable model, and you compare it with the conformal field theory. So, in conformal field theory, the fields are counted by Virasoro algebra. But of course, so when you make a perturbation, integral perturbation, this is broken. So then you have to think how to count local operators in the integrable model. And in this integrable models of which are close to Liouville, okay, sine Gordon, sinh Gordon, this kind of case, and more than that. So the operators are counted. So there are some. So we have these primary fields, and on primary fields, some fermions are acting. So there are two of them for each chirality, and so then so I denote this multi indices here like that, yes. So and so I take this guys with the only requirement that the number total number of betas is equal to total number of gammas, and I claim that this give me a set of all the descendants of this phi and Virasoro descendants of this phi. So there is correspondence between these guys and the Virasoro descendants of this phi and some shifted phis. And so which is the relation is exact. And that for this, when I count operators like that, then these one-point functions or these matrix elements are easy to compute. So let's see. General rule is that I have this yes. So but if the number of elements in M is the same as number of elements in N, and consequently for another chirality, you have just conformal in the UV limit, you have just conformal descendants of this field. If they are different, so then you have conformal descendants of this shifted field. And so here, to be precise, so this is, so if this is a conformal descendants of the shifted field, and it is defined like that, and there is some definition of so how I understand the operators with negative indices, and they are of course annihilation operations like that. So this, I will not need these formulas in generality. So let's skip them for the moment. So, and then the claim is that a matrix, that the ratio of matrix element of this fermionic descendant by the matrix element of the primary field is given by determinant of these are sets of integers, yes, so determinant of some matrix omega mn with some simple addition, and this omega mn is the only physical input, so all the rest as you see is more or less combinatorics, which you need to compute the one-point function in this model. And so now, here I must say that for this case, I cannot derive this formula, but so I just guess it's kind of a little bit out of the blue. By analogy with other, my procedure is I guess this thing by analogy with the other cases, and then I check the limits, like conformal limit, and the,
what is it? Omega, what is it?
Yes, it will be here. I guess it, yes. I did not. I will.
There's still some formula.
Yes, some formula. So, let me see. What is it? Yes, so this is exactly what why I said that there are some there is a similarity with what Samson and Nikita were doing, in some case alpha equals zero, this function omega this omega mn is nothing like Gaussian, so of the matrix of second derivative with respect to higher times of more or less like that, yes, of this Young action.
Doesn't it remind
the square
norm
of
the
Petrov
function?
Not exactly, because so you see this is interesting point, because so look, what is Young, what is the action of Young and Young, yes, it depends on the beta roots, yes, and so when you differentiate with respect to beta roots, yes, and make the determinant, so you get your norm of the beta function, but it can also depend. So this is out of shell, yes. So because you differentiate with respect, yes. But suppose now that you have external parameters like inhomogeneity, for example, in your spin chain, yes, and you compute on shell, and then differentiate with respect to these guys, and this will be.
It's not that the yes. Okay.
Well, spiritually it is, because in some big space it is. Those two things are indistinguishable.
In big space, everything is the same. Yes. Depends how big the space is.
How correctly.
Okay, so. You remember I had this function f, yes, for when I characterized the discrete spectrum, equation for discrete spectrum. Now using this, I derive that the derivative with respect to the radius of this epsilon function, and it looks like that. And motivated by this formula, I introduce the convolution, so which is kind of normal from the function analysis point of view. So so you have functions which have continuous spectrum, and discrete spectrum. And you have a measure which is a part of measure is continuous and the part of measure is discrete. So there is a convolution like that.
It's like positive, the square of g, 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 g will be positive. You put j equal to h will be positive?
Yeah, I think so, yes. 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 So, and then this omega is a simple thing. You take just a kernel like this, 2 by 2, not 2 by 2, but so discrete spectrum and continuous spectrum. So kernel like that. So and this composed of these guys, which deform the kernels which you have in TBA, and so then a vector like this. So these are for discrete spectrum, and this is for continuous spectrum. And so you sandwich the resolvent for this kernel with this measure, yes, between these two guys, n and m, and you get my omega. So
that's a definition of omega.
Not so bad, yes? Okay. So now, I started this work with Bajnok, because these guys in Budapest, they like very much this kind of matrix elements. So and the write for them formulae of the type of Leclerc and Mozart, I will not, which are good for writing the series for large R. Yes, but and so then this, of course, the formula are complicated, but they can be compared with this simple formula which I explained with this omega, and or they give the same, of course. But so for me this is not so interesting. So I want to see what will happen in the ultraviolet limit when the radius of cylinder is small and when I should be in touch with Liouville. So I consider the ultraviolet limit, and so Liouville on a cylinder. So of course when I am a conformal field theory, in conformal limit, so I would probably map this cylinder to a sphere. But so I want to speak such a language that which is well for conformal and deformed, in conformal and deformed case. So I will still stay on a cylinder. So then you remember, so I had this picture. So I have the energy momentum tensor, and I take the coordinate on my cylinder. So I cylinder is my what is chok? So I take that, which belongs to this, and so either I define two Virasoro algebras, either local one, which is around z equals zero, so where my local operator lives, or global ones, which are around the cylinder, yes? And so this defines me L small and L capital. And now I am interested in matrix elements of conformal fields between two fields, between two states psi, and this psi are descendants created by these guys, and this O are Virasoro descendants of my primary field. So the dimension of primary of the field is like that in my notations.
Normalization is the same? Normalization is the same?
Like according to Lukianov's homological. Yeah. For this thing.
Yes. No. For the primary field.
For the primary field, yes, 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 with this Lukyanov-Zamolodchikov normalization, yes, exactly. Mm-hmm.
In CFT, so you say U will limit, it's a CFT.
Yes.
And now you say in CFT, that's what it's calculated.
Yes.
From CFT point of view, it's a full correlation function, or it's a...
Three-point function.
Three-point function, but...
Full. It's not so easy. So, exactly. So, and here I write this transparency. You can check if you wish so. So these are for example, here this is descendant L minus two descendant of primary field, and so between two primary fields. So delta plus one means the first descendant. So the first descendant is unique. So I allow myself to write this not very nice probably. Notation. Yes, and so now what I promised to say, and so we can see the UV limit of my local operators, so created by fermions, and the claim is that they are I write here in the simplest cases, but I can compute as far as you wish. So that they are related, and I did not say one important thing, that of course I compute everything modular descendants of by local integrals of motion, because so descendants of local integrals of motion they do not contribute to this one point function, because to the left and to the right I have the same thing. Yes. So this means modular action of local integrals of motion. So the formula are like that for the simplest case. So these are for one chirality. So I create L minus two by these two fermions. I create L minus two square and L minus four by these two fermions. And so you see there are two descendants. Modular local integrals of motion. There are two descendants, and I take descendants modular local integrals of motion as being created by even Virasoro generators, and so you see. So from here I can find L minus two squared and L minus four if I wish, re-express in terms of fermions, and so on.
Sorry, for this lesson, the case when number of operators of equal chirality coincide.
Yes, it will be soon. Yes, it will be soon. So this is as you say correctly. So this is here I take the case when the number of operators coincide, and so moreover, only one chirality. I could put here so the other they don't interfere. Yes, and so these are our favorite functions. So. We are very proud about these ones. Okay. So then I compute my function omega. I don't know when and how they became capital. I don't remember. But so these are my functions omega. And so what I am saying is that in the limit of when r goes to zero, they must be given according to everything, so all I said above, they must be given by these expressions. And so this thing we know, so I mean, was written and so on and so forth, so everything is known here. This can be checked. So, and then we come to the next question, so to your question. So, if I take for the simplest case when I act by beta star. And gamma one bar, so this is allowed, yes. Then it shifts the primary field. So that's what happens. And so then what I have to, what the ratio of this of the three-point function for this shifted shifted primary field over over three-point function for unshifted one is given. It can be read, from Dorn. Who else? Dorn. Otto Dorn, Zamolochikov, Zamolochikov. Of course, I read from Zamolochikov and Zamolochikov for me. But anyway, so, and so and here is f, which is the ratio of these two Lukyanov-Zamolochikov functions, a mess like that. And we so this must be the UV limit of this omega 1 minus 1. Already it's more interesting because here I have something fractional power and so on. So more exciting. Yes. So now and so I how do I do? I check numerically. So and I check numerically for R equal 10 to minus 3. A is for some reason is like that, B is like that, so I don't want them to be, you know, I want to avoid all possible resonances, so I don't want them to be kind of similar. And for simplicity, here I start with, I consider the case when no descendants with respect to other chirality, and so here is numerics. I don't know what to say.
So something coincides with something?
Yes, so this is CFT, for example, omega 1, 1, yes? So this is numerical, which I give from my equation. And this is CFT. So here you see, so this coincides. But this is, then the descendants are getting nastier. So here, for example, L equal, even no descendants. So this is a primary field number 4, primary field number 4. And so here it is, okay, so not so good, but more or less all right. So good. So that's why it seems that my conjecture is correct. And so then I want to consider, so just I have some time here. So I want to consider the simplest case why L minus 1. With degenerate L0, yes? So on level 2, I have two operators, two vectors. So I two vectors, L minus 2, L minus 1 squared. So, and now the first integral of motion, which is essentially L0, do not distinguish between them. And I have to think about the next integral of motion, which is I3. So I3 is like that. So easy to compute. From because easy to compute from the fact that the density of I3 is t squared. So now this guy acts on these two vectors. It gives me some matrix with this eigenvalues and these eigenvectors, and I must identify them with what I get from my numerics, and so I compute the integrals of motion from this TBA, and so these are, I take this once again, this parameters, and so this is what I get in CFT, I think, and this is or vice versa, and this is what I get by TBA, and so this is how I say that this guy corresponds to this one, and this guy corresponds to this one, and in natural notation, so now I have these two vectors, so L minus, I don't remember who is first, who is second. L minus 2 is first and L minus 1 squared is second. So I have this matrix of for, yes. And so then L minus 2 of this guy is given by this one, and so with this matrix element, so and this, so this is, I believe me, it is true, and so now this thing omega 1 1 plus minus in this case, yes, is given by this formula where I use this this vector psi for eigenvalues of integrals of motion of degenerate, and so these are the eigenvalues in this case for the minus guy and for the plus guy for the descendant and for shifted primary field, and you see that probably they are not as good as before, but so all right.
From CFT point of view, it's a generic situation, right? You are not.
Yes. Yes.
So
oh, yeah. No, that's
generic.
Mm-hmm. So, and so this is the end of the talk, almost. So, and to finish, I want to say that with so for a long time with Samson, it returns. So we were discussing some very nice Georgian film. Which was after poems of some Georgian poet whose name is Vaja Pshavela, and so I do not know where the British English translation exists, and I cannot write or read in Georgian, so that's why I give you some Russian translation by Tsvetaeva. Okay.
And Tsvetaeva was a great poet. Another guy, Vaja Pshavela, was a genius. Now, if I translate them, what it makes me?
and the point is that there is another translation of the same poem by Mandelstam, and this is completely. So I looked at the same piece. Completely different. Even the.
Ask Gregory ask. He is a more expert.
Can you translate?
Yeah.
No. Do you recognize the original?
No. Spirit.
Spirit is all right.
Ask Google to do it.
This is when one guy was attacked by another one. First it starts when his wife tells him that we are poor because you have to rob somebody, so because otherwise, so and he does not want. So and then he is attacked by somebody, so he confines him, and then they drink together. So at some point.
These are very high mountains, higher than yours.
Are ready for coffee? What do we get out of this for Liouville? Something interesting if you start going the other way around?
For Liouville? I don't know. So actually, I would say that. So yeah, I did not say that. Why would you be interested in this diagonal matrix elements? Yes. So and so one question, one answer is that if you want to make a one-point function on a torus, then you will start probably summing up these diagonal matrix elements, yes? And so, but the question is whether it is possible using this technique to write this, somehow to simplify the expression for the one-point function on the torus, because this is not easy even for conformal case, yes? So this probably will help, I don't know.
One-point function also called modernization and
condensed
memory, which is very important stuff.
One-point function. So you see. So if why one-point function? Because so if you want to compute the correlation, general correlation functions using the OPE is a perturbation. You obtain OPE in. Okay. So. Not so easy, but so more or less you obtain OPE from perturbation of conformal field theory, yes? And then by OPE you reduce your multi-point function to one, but then it's not enough to know a one-point function of one operator or two operator, but you have to know for everybody, yes? So that's what I'm doing.
Yeah,